Hello and welcome to Birmingham. I'm Greg Sugden, Head of Delivery for the Curzon Approaches at High Speed 2. In this video, we're going to focus on the network of structures that will carry our trains into the heart of Birmingham city centre. When High Speed 2 trains surface out of the Bromford Tunnel, just a few miles to the east of here at Washwood Heath, they'll travel across a 5 kilometre series of bridges and viaducts before arriving here behind me into Birmingham Curzon Street Station. We call this stretch of the High Speed 2 route the Curzon Approaches. Right behind me, you can see where we're building a brand new Curzon Street Station, set to become a key destination and thriving departure point as part of Britain's new high-speed railway. Once built, this station will strengthen Birmingham's transport connections, support the regeneration of East Side and Digworth, and play a vital role in the long-term economic future of the West Midlands. The railway will transform the passenger experience with reliable, fast, zero-carbon travel. This section in Birmingham traverses through both industrial and densely residential areas to connect with our West Midlands terminus. And it's fair to say that the urban nature of the approaches presents various challenges. Here in Birmingham, significant progress has already been made, as you can see. As we follow the route into the city, you can see the railway taking shape, whether here in the heart of Birmingham or in the east near Washwood Heath. We're bringing together the best of British design and engineering, supporting thousands of jobs and boosting investment around our new Birmingham station, years before services even begin. In fact, research shows that in the West Midlands alone, High Speed 2 will drive a £10 billion boost to the economy over the next 10 years. Our journey begins in Water Orton, a village in North Warwickshire, right at the eastern entrance of the impressive 3.5-mile-long Bromford Tunnel. The tunnel will be used as the gateway into Birmingham. At the eastern portal, two colossal tunnel boring machines, or TBMs as we call them, have been launched. The first has nearly completed its epic journey, while the second is already past the halfway point, making great progress underground. Just a short distance away in Washwood Heath, a team has carved out a 22-metre deep reception portal. The team has completed this excavation and prepared the space for the TBM's arrival. Behind the colossal earthworks operation, a skilled team of over 130 people who have excavated over 37,000 metres cubed of material to create the portal. At the other end of Bromford Tunnel, Western Portal, we have a beginning of the Washwood Heath retained cut, excavating over 180,000 metres cubed. Alongside a 40-hectare platform construction that will house the High Speed 2 maintenance depot, where our trains will be maintained, serviced and stored when not in use. The cut is a passageway which will take High Speed 2 trains from the tunnel into the open at the ground level, taking them from deep underground to the daylight and on their way to the city centre here. Trains making their way into Birmingham will pass under the Aston Church Road Overbridge located in Saltley. The new bridge is 84 metres long and spans the busy existing Birmingham to Derby railway lines, and it will sit above the new High Speed 2 tracks. The new bridge will be a vital link for pedestrians, allowing the public to cross over, connecting the neighbourhoods of Saltley, Washwood Heath and Neatrals in north-east Birmingham. The bridge design itself was influenced by feedback from the local community, and features include enhanced LED lighting, weathered steel panels with a unique perforated pattern, and the introduction of new green spaces for everyone to enjoy. The 1,600-ton steel and concrete bridge was built beside the existing railway, then moved into position in just 5 hours. It rests on three key structures, two abutments and a pier made of two columns. Currently, works are progressing with utility diversions, and the construction of the approaches to connect the existing highway and roundabout is ongoing. Eventually, the existing bridge will be demolished to create extra space for the High Speed 2 line to pass through and continue its journey onto the approach to Curzon Street Station. After passing under the bridge, trains will pass over the Saltley Canal, just 2 miles away from the Birmingham city centre. At this point, we encounter the Saltley Canal Underbridge, a vital piece of infrastructure that will carry the High Speed 2 line across the Grand Union Canal. This structure is split into two decks. One deck will support the two tracks of the High Speed 2 main line, while the other will carry two tracks connecting to the Washwood Heath depot. Right now, we're hard at work installing the permanent piles at the north abutment of the canal, having already completed the piling to the south abutment. Work on the south abutment has now shifted to prepare for the sheet filing phase that will enable the excavation and construction of the abutment itself. And the preparation will begin for the fabrication of steel decks, where the deck of the bridge will be lifted into position over the canal. Alongside the bridge will sit the new Saltley Viaduct. Like Aston Church Road Overbridge, there's already an existing bridge in this location, and it's an important crossing point providing access to the city centre and the districts of Neatrals and Allen Rock. To replace the existing structure, we're building a new Saltley Viaduct, which will pass over the Grand Union Canal, High Speed 2 lines and the Network Rail tracks. The spans consist of steel beams and composite reinforced concrete deck. Once the new superstructure is fabricated, it will be driven into its final position over the existing Network Rail tracks. At the moment, the team are working on constructing the east abutment, which is located to the east side of the canal. Later this year, they will start piling works on the central piers and the west abutment. Trains will pass under the viaduct and will gradually rise as the railway ascends Saltley retained fill. The fill is a continuous retaining wall acting as a barrier between the High Speed 2 tracks and the existing Network Rail tracks. After the tracks pass beneath Saltley Viaduct, the size of the walls increase in height as the tracks rise towards the Duddeston Junction Viaduct. These retaining walls consist of cast in situ reinforced concrete L-shaped walls as pile foundations. The first phase of this work is complete and we're now preparing the area to become the launch platform of the Duddeston Junction Viaduct. Rising 12 metres high, the viaduct marks the beginning of the path towards the future Curzon Street Station. The Duddeston Junction Viaduct stretches over 600 metres across a highly urbanised landscape. But building this structure in such a busy area comes with its challenges. Surrounded by Network Rail tracks, major utilities and a busy road crossing, space is really at a premium. Before the main construction work could commence, the team had to divert several Network Rail tracks onto a newly built Duddeston Mill Road underbridge, which was placed into position using a 750-ton crane, a huge operation in itself. Now the viaduct is interfacing with more tracks, particularly in the complex area we refer to as the island, a critical junction in the project. The works here are incredibly complex, and they lie between live tracks, making it an on-track live work site with added safety and precision requirements. Right now, the team is hard at work constructing 17 piers. Unlike other viaducts, this one uses two different types of pier design. There'll be 10 steel piers and 7 concrete piers, including a wing wall. The concrete piers are being constructed using a traditional method with multiple concrete pours taking place. Meanwhile, the steel piers are being installed using a variety of cranes from 350 to 750 tons, which carefully lift the steel sections into position. Looking ahead, we're now preparing to install a gantry crane, a vital piece of machinery that will support the construction of the viaduct deck. The gantry crane will assemble the deck spans and carefully launch them across the piers. This crane will be installed in the Saltley retained fill, where it will anchor securely to the structure. Where the gantry crane's capability is limited due to working conditions, the beams will be lifted into position. Space constraints here affect everything, the work methodology and the sequence of works. But with every challenge, the team continues to push forward, building Britain's high-speed future. The next section of structures on our journey are the Curzon No. 1 and Curzon No. 2 viaducts, which seamlessly connect with the Duddeston Junction Viaduct. Hazel, our site engineer, has been working on these viaducts. Here they are to give more detail on this section of the Curzon approaches.
We're currently standing at Curzon No. 1 and Curzon No. 2 viaduct. Behind me are the Curzon 1 piers. The permanent works began in 2023, with piling followed by formwork, reinforcement and concrete works, which were completed in 2024. The construction involved over 1,000 tonnes of rebar and over 10,000 cubic metres of structural concrete. Now there is only two piers remaining to be constructed. The process of building these piers has been carried out in stages, from site preparation and foundation works to the construction of the pier shaft and finally the finishing touches. Meanwhile, the Curzon No. 2 viaduct has already seen all four piers completed on either side of the railway. And now we are shifting our focus to constructing the deck. What you see on top of these piers is what will be the deck of the viaduct. These steel beams have been brought together on site through a process of cutting, welding and lifting. This structure is a truss bridge, a design where triangular units are connected to form a stable formwork. The truss is assembled on the ground and lifted into position on top of Curzon No. 1 viaduct, as we are seeing right now. As you can see behind me, we are currently preparing on site to lift our first diagonal, which will form part of our vertical deck. The weight of the diagonal is 80 tons. As this is a tandem list, it will be listed using two cranes, the 200 ton and the 400 ton. After it will be moved into its final position, where the welders will be welding it together using the MEUPs. The purpose of the MEUP is to ensure our welders will get from the ground level up to the height in order to weld the element together. We are currently standing on top of the working platform. This platform is used for the installation of various elements of the truss, such as the crossbeams, which you can see above me, and the stringers. These beams then get welded together and quality inspected and tested. Once complete, the stunning weathering steel curved truss will soar 40 metres into the sky, becoming an iconic part of Birmingham's skyline. The next phase will be launching the bridge into the final position over the existing railway during a 9-day launching operation. This entire deck will be slid into Curzon No. 1 viaduct, moving 190 metres into place using a precise jacking system. The structure will then sit firmly on the Curzon No. 2 piers, completing the assembly. What makes this 25-metre high truss stand out is a striking new light installation, which will not only transform the city skyline during the day, but it will also shine at night, becoming an eye-catching landmark. In fact, it will be the tallest structure among all the approaches of Curzon Street Station, making it a defining feature of the city's future landscape.
As passengers journey across the iconic Curzon 2 Viaduct, their route brings them towards the Lawley Middleway Viaduct. Later this year, the viaduct, built right on site here, will be launched over a busy A road below, right here in central Birmingham, allowing the high-speed trains to pass above. The viaduct's launch section, an impressive 116 metres in length, will be carefully manoeuvred into place using a combination of methods, like SPMTs, which are self-propelled modular transporters, and skidding shoe systems around the bridge piers. These techniques will help position the span over the road one step closer to completion. Once the span is launched, the team will lift pre-assembled steel sections onto piers and supports, subsequently welding them into position. We're now onto the final stretch towards Birmingham Curzon Street Station. This is the point where the Lawley Middleway Viaduct transitions into the final, most advanced viaduct of the approaches. Behind me stands the impressive 300 metre long Curzon No. 3 Viaduct. As the viaduct approaches Curzon Street Station, watch as the deck transforms from a single structure at the eastern end to four distinct fingers at the western end, designed to guide tracks into the 7 platform station. The design maximises natural light in the spacious and flexible public area beneath, creating a vibrant, open environment. Refinements in the design have resulted in reduced concrete use, making the viaduct not only more sustainable, but also more beneficial for the environment and the local community. The unique V-shaped piers support the viaduct, taking up less space at ground level. You can see that the viaduct is well developed. Much of the deck is already in place, with the remaining connection to Lawley Middleway remaining. At the western end, the V-shaped piers are substituted for the four inverted steel piers, which reference the heritage of the canal side cranes here in Birmingham. The canal here will remain a visually attractive area to the public, combining 21st century high-speed 2 infrastructure with the 19th century Digbeth Canal area. As we head towards Curzon Street Station, the final stages of this viaduct will be built by our main station contractor team, connecting seamlessly to the station, which is set to become a key destination and thriving departure point for the railway. The station will be the first brand new intercity terminus to be built in Britain since the 19th century. Once operational, the new station will bring High Speed 2 right here into the city centre of Birmingham. Our British-built high-speed trains will operate on these new dedicated tracks, offering high-speed intercity travel while creating much-needed capacity on the existing rail network. High Speed 2 will transform local services and provide faster, low-carbon journeys between London, Birmingham and beyond. Thank you for watching this update. As you can see, we're making great progress on this stretch of the new high-speed route, but there's much more to do and many challenges ahead. We'll be sure to keep you updated as we deliver Britain's new high-speed future.